In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how I made this boho style dream catcher. What I love so much about this is that you can switch up the beads and feathers and the colors of thread and yarn that you use to really make it your own. Everything I used in this was bought at Joann's Fabrics. I will link everything that you could possibly need for this below, but probably any craft store near you will have what you need. So let's go ahead and get into the tutorial. The first thing you'll need is a hoop. This one is a 10-inch hoop. And then you'll need a crochet doily. And this one's an 8-inch doily. You'll also need feathers and beads. These ones are glow in the dark, which will be cool. And then some yarn. This you might not need, but it's just some crafting wire, usually in the jewelry aisle. This one is macrame cord and embroidery needles. And then of course the thread that you're gonna use. You don't have to use as many as I did. I just wanted to have multiple colors. And then of course scissors. So the first step is going to be to thread your threads through your embroidery needle. And I can see on my doily here, on each scallop, I have several holes, and those are gonna be the holes I use to attach it to the hoop. So I'm gonna start by going down through the first hole. And when you pull it through, pull it all the way completely through until you only have a few inches of thread left. And I should have mentioned this, but cut way more thread than you think you'll need. It's always good to have way too much and then cut it rather than get almost to the end and find you have too little. So then just go around the hoop and then down through the next hole, around the hoop, down through the next hole. And don't worry too much about making this perfectly centered because you will be able to adjust once you get all the way around the hoop. So once you've worked your way around the hoop, go through the last hole, and then this is where you can kind of tighten and loosen and adjust as needed. And then once you've adjusted to your liking, cut off the excess thread and go ahead and tie and double knot it to your hoop. And then I tied and double knotted again just to be safe. And I did this extra step that you really don't need to do. It's probably not necessary. I just really wanted it to be secure on there, so I cut some of that crafting wire and I sort of like pretzeled it around that knot just to really hold it in place. And then once you've done this step, you can go ahead and hang it on the wall and we will get to the rest of it. Okay, so all of the yarn and the macrame cord that I showed you earlier, I cut into lots of different really long strips. And then what you take each strip and you line up the ends, you take the middle part of it around your hoop and then you pull the strands through. So you're just tying lark's heads knots. And if you need to know how to do those knots, I will link my macrame knots for beginners video below and it'll show you exactly how to do that. But you're gonna do the same knot over and over for all of the yarn that you cut and all of the macrame cord. So I'm just adding sort of different shades of purple and pink in along with the macrame. So then I felt like it was a little too bare, so I went ahead and after this, I grabbed some pink yarn and I cut three strips together and I tied them on together just to add some more volume and kind of add some different texture. And then I went ahead and I did braid the pink one. And I'm gonna add a few more of those pink ones of three strips together in there just to once again add some more volume and texture. Thank you. And this is where you can get really creative and kind of do whatever you want to do. You can do braiding, you can do various knots, and that's what makes it so fun. So here I'm just threading some beads onto the string. I've kind of threaded some randomly throughout and knotted them, but I'm showing here how I do it. I just thread the beads through, and then to tie a barrel knot, I just go around once, twice, three times, and then pull it down through and tighten. But however you do it, just tie a knot underneath your beads, and then I just stick the feather right up through the beads, and you can always tie an extra bit of thread around the bottom just to make sure that it's super secure, but it kind of works out perfectly like that. So I added two feathers to either side, and then I'm also going to add random beads throughout, and I'm going to add a set of beads with a feather in the very center. So like I said, there's the center feather, and then I'm just gonna start tying random knots with the macrame cord in different spots just to add some more different textures and make it a little more interesting. And then I'm also going to be fraying out the bottom of some of those macrame cords. And you can kind of wait until the end to see how you want to cut the bottoms. I've already trimmed them a bit, but you can always adjust at the end. So cut it however you'd like, and then that's pretty much it. You just kind of keep adding little elements until you're satisfied with it. And this is mine. I also added a second feather to that middle section there. I hope that this was helpful. I hope you found it super easy as well. And I hope you give this video a like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching.